Yeah, hello brothers and sisters, welcome again today to this our program, and I'm happy to see you again, and I'm happy to happen to search the Bible, which is the doctrine of our Lord Jesus Christ, to find out something that we have to discuss today. So what we're trying to discuss today is nothing but the anger of God upon those who deceive people, upon those who use the name of God in vain, upon those who give God a bad name, upon the so-called pastors, the fake prophecies, the fake prophet themselves and their fake prophecies. There's anger of God in the book of Romans chapter 1 from verse 28. Romans chapter 1 from verse 28. And I want to narrate something, I want to bring something closer to your understanding there. I told you before that it's not every house that they wrote the name of God is a church of God. It's not a place you saw they wrote something like a Kingdom of Heaven Church of God, or Jehovah's Witness Church of God, or Christ the King Church of God. All these things does not signify that there is God in there. There are some of these things that you enter that you think that is church, is not church. Some of them are house that is built in the name of God, but the activities inside that houses are the activities of the devil, and God do not condemn to these houses. And there's things that is going on there which you might think that things are going well because God is with them. No, Jose, there's nothing like something happening there that make you think that God is there. Oh, this person is not having a problem, this person is not having problem, whatever he do, he go free from it. It's not because that God is with him. There are some people that God have already say they are gone case. There are some people that God have caught gone case, and those people, he said that you don't need to pray to God to forgive these people. You don't need to pray for their sins because they are gone case in the sight of God. There are some of the things they are doing that is because God have overlooked them. God have said, it's okay, let them, they are no more in account of my children. So whatever they do, whatever they did, devil can prosper them, and devil can give them whatever they want. Instead, even if devil don't care the name you're calling, even if you call the name of Jesus Christ, and devil know that what you're doing, God have already abandoned you. Devil don't care whether you call Jesus name or whether you call God name, or as long as he know that at the last time you are coming to hellfire. That is what devil is out for. He don't care the name you call. So you don't be deceived when people call the name of Jesus in every churches or in every house. You think that, okay, these people are calling in the name of Jesus and this is happening here. It's not really the issue. The issue is not where the name is called. Because if you can go to the book of Romans chapter 1 verse 28 now, let us go to the Bible and you can understand what I'm trying to say. In the book of Romans chapter 1 verse 28 says, and even as they did not like to retain God in their knowledge, God gave them over to a based mind to do things which are not fitting. God have already given them up to this mind, have already given them up, you know, give up. When somebody said, man, I give up already, it means God have already given up. God have already given them chance to change. God have already given them a lot of time to come back, but it seems not working. That's why God said, that's why the Bible is trying to tell us now that God have already given them up already. Even they can do anything, it's okay, go ahead and do, because I know you cannot change, because he's the God that know where the end from the beginning. You know that there's no more, you are gone. So when you're under this type of people, whatever they're doing, you know they're criminals. You know that they do things, they consult evil. They come in the congregation and they do things, and things start working from the power of the devil. And devil know you. Remember, the devil say, Jesus I know, Paul I know, who are you? Devil knows you. He know that you're being abandoned by God. He know that these people have been abandoned by God. And the only way the devil can use them is to make them to retain that the rank they think they're getting. You know, to make them to remain in that high position on the face of men. You know, some are very high places, some are in the high pastoral rank, as they call it, pastor or something like that. Some already in the high places like that, and they don't want to come down, they don't want to bow down to the God of the God of heaven. They don't want to bow down to God Almighty. Instead of them to bow down, instead of them to know, instead of them to rethink inside them and know that what they have been teaching people all this while is wrong, they can't take that shame. Instead, they will keep on going on because God have already given up on them. God have already given up totally on them. As he said in the book of Romans chapter 1 verse 28, he already given up to them. He's giving up. God doesn't care anymore. So whatever these people do, let me tell you, if you're among these people, and even if you're under the churches like this, the only one church I recognize on earth is the church of God, which the doctrine is from Bible, totally from Bible. But I'm not here to talk about church. I'm here to talk about God itself. I'm here to talk about what is going on and the wrong way people are leading you to. So what I'm trying to tell you now is, this sin, you're a partaker to it. Let's read that. I hope you're with your Bible there. You can go to Romans chapter 1 verse 28. I'm reading from there. I'm on 20 now. He said, being filled with all unrighteousness, sexual immorality, wickedness, covetousness. Oh, let us go back there. Let us go back. Or let me go. I don't know how to explain it to you. I hope you're with your Bible there. I'm very, very happy if you're with your Bible, because I don't want you to say you hear it from my mouth. I want you to read it and understand it by yourself. I'm only going to narrate it to you. This is all this from 29 to 30 is exactly what is going on there. Okay, if you can go to the 30, he said, backbiters, haters of God, violent, proud, boasters. Proud. They are proud. Their hands are up. When they are coming to preach, there will be bodyguards. How many bodyguards follow our Lord Jesus Christ, if not his disciples? There will be bodyguards. They wear black eyeglasses. They will be looking. They will put their security gadgets on their ears. What is going on? This is proud. The proud have already entered them. They make you feel that if you're poor, you're forbidden by God. But it is them that are forbidden by God. No matter what they are doing, no matter how much they are rich, no matter how much they are progressing in whatever they are doing, this does not concern God again. Because if you can go through with me on this verse 28 down to 30, you will find out that there is proud in them. Okay, let's go up there again. Even teens disobedient to parents. Disobedient to parents. Unforgiving. Unmerciful. Remember, in the 32 it says, who knowing the righteous judgment of God, that those who practice such things are deserving of death. Not only do they sin, but also approval of those who practice them. Amen. It's not only them that are deserving this death. Spiritual death is what the Bible is trying to tell us here. They are dead, but they are walking. They're living dead. He said that this day does not base on them alone, but you who are partakers of this. Read the last verse. He said, not only do they say, but also approval of those who practice them. You approval of them. You clap. That's why I ask you, in whose church, in whose house do you worship God? Do you worship God in the house of the devil? Or do you worship devil in the house of God, in the house that is called the name of God? There are some houses that are called the name of God, but they are worshiping devil. And devil know that these people are worshiping them. God is not a magician. I said it before, and I'm still saying it again. God cannot make you rich to prove that He loves you. God cannot make you poor to prove that He overlooks you. God can only give away. God can only give up, give you up. God can only wash His hand off you. As the Bible said in the book of Romans chapter 1 verse 28 down to 30, God can only wash off His hand on you. You can be whatever you want to be. You can do whatever you want to do. You can be whoever you want to be. You can make names by yourself. You can deceive millions of people. They will follow you. You will call the name of Jesus. Who cares? Devil knows where you're going at the last time. Even the angels know. So you and you are the only two people that know yourself. You and God. There's no amount of explanation. There's no amount of introduction that you can do to somebody to tell him all about yourself. No way. The person that knows you better is you and God. So you know yourself. You so-called pastors, you so-called men of God, you so-called priests, you so-called reverend fathers, you so-called whosoever you're called to be. But you are inside that place doing what is abominable in the sight of God. The repercussion is coming. And I pity those people that followed you, and I pity those people that are following your footstep. Because the Bible said that my people have perished out of ignorance. They don't know. Because they don't know, they are perished. And you take the disadvantages of this their unknowing, and make use of them. You that taught and you that teach them, you that feel, you that think that you are spiritually gifted, but you are misusing it. But you think that you can make money from people by calling the name of Jesus. I tell you, the sufferings that you're going to receive in the end of the time will be worse to you that you don't even try it. Enough is enough. Enough is enough. It's a time you go inside your house. It's a time you off your TV. It's a time you off your handset. You children of God, it's a time you off your phone. It's a time you off your television. It's a time you off your computers. And it's a time you off your laptop and carry on your Bible. Think about God in a minute. I gave you an example last time. I said, if you can only think about heaven for 2 days, you will be as holy as any angel. Just forget about this earth. Forget about any trouble. If you can go inside anywhere, go. I learned that people go to the mountain. What do you go to the mountain to do? To chat and tear yourself and do baseless offering? And do some fasting, suffer your skin. Jesus said, they will not fast because they are with me until I gone, then they will fast. But if you are a child of God, you will not let Jesus to go out of your life so that you cannot fast. Because if your Jesus is in you, you don't need to fast because you are already on the righteous lane. Jesus made that comment because these people accused his disciples, said, why is your disciple are not fasting? But we are fasting. He said, because they are with the God. Because they are with me, they cannot fast. Until I go, then they will fast. They can fast. That's a word for you to understand that you don't need to let Jesus get out of your life. Why are you fasting? Because you thought He's left. Well, He's always with you, as He promised. He said, I'm always with you till the end of the time. So don't be deceived when they give you all these 7 days, 20 days, 40 days, and whenever you finish it, things that is happening to you is still happening to you. Then does it mean that God is wicked? No, God is not wicked. They just want to give God a bad name. For you to think that God is wicked, for you to think that God hates you, God doesn't hate you. God loves you more than you think. It's only that you don't know how to worship God. It's only that you don't know how to recognize God. It's only that you don't know how to appreciate God in your life. Because if you can know how to appreciate God in your life, anything that you put your hand will be prosperous. Well, let's talk about prosperity. Prosperity of souls, not prosperity of money. Not prosperity of worldly things. Your soul will be prospered. As long as your soul prospers.